So far we have seen there are a number of flukes that can cause infection in the humans, and usually the flukes resides in different areas of the human body. But the most important flukes that is encountered, that is the schistosome, the genus schistosomes, and they are called blood flukes because they resides in the venous plexuses of human. That's why they are called the blood flukes. The disease caused by schistosome species is in general called schistosomiasis or bilharziasis. Under the genus schistosome, there are three important species. One is schistosoma hematobium. This flukes or schistosoma hematobium, this usually resides in the vesical plexus of vein. And the other species are Schistosoma mensoni and Schistosoma japonicum. They usually resides into the mesenteric plexus of veins. The Schistosoma mensoni and Schistosoma japonicum affect the gastrointestinal tract, whereas Schistosoma hematobium affects the urinary tract. Because of their presence in the different venous plexuses, that causes different infection in the different places. So we know that these flukes or trematodes has different properties from the cystodes. And among the trematodes, like the liver flukes or intestinal flukes, there is a big difference of these blood flukes with the other flukes. The schistosomes they have many different characteristics than the other flukes. So let us see what are the important properties of these schistosomes. We know that trematodes do not have separate sex. They are hermaphrodite, but in case of schistosomes, they are separate sex. That means male schistosome and female schistosome, but they live attached. The male worm is smaller than the female worm, and the male worm has a gynophoric canal into which the female resides. Female worm resides. They always remain attached and continuously producing eggs. There is a distinction between the eggs of the schistosomes with the other trematodes. The eggs of schistosomes are not operculated, whereas the schistosomes of other trematodes are operculated. The eggs of Schistosoma mensoni and Schistosoma japonicum has lateral spine. The eggs of the Schistosoma mensoni and Schistosoma japonicum has lateral spine. But in case of Schistosoma hematobium, there is a prominent terminal spine. If you look through the pictures of eggs of these schistosomes, you will clearly see that the eggs of the Schistosoma hematobium has a prominent terminal spine, and the other schistosome has lateral spine. These are the important distinguishing feature for identifying these eggs in the urine or stool, and also to differentiate the eggs of Schistosoma hematobium with other schistosomes. The Schistosoma mensoni and Schistosoma japonicum adult live in the mesenteric vein, whereas the Schistosoma hematobium lives in the veins draining the urinary bladder. So let us start with the life cycle of Schistosoma hematobium. The trematodes of other species may use one or more intermediate host to complete this life cycle. In case of Schistosoma, the definitive host is the vertebrates or human, and the intermediate host is the freshwater snail. The infective form for human or vertebrate is the fork-tailed freely swimming Sarcaria. Humans are infected when free swimming forktail sakatya penetrate the skin. They differentiate to larva or schistosomula or young schistosome in the subcutaneous tissue. Here they may give rise to papules or erythematous reaction due to the hypersensitivity to this young larva or schistosomula. This schistosomula then enter the blood and are carried via the veins into the arterial circulation. So in the arterial circulation by superior mesenteric artery, they pass into the portal circulation and reach in the liver. So liver is one of the most important organ where the schistosome, this young schistosomes resides. So in liver, this larva matures into the adult flukes. So here in liver, there will be a number of pathogenicity which we will discuss later on. The mature adult flukes then migrates into the mesenteric plexus of veins or the vesical plexus of veins. Schistosoma mansoni and Schistosoma japonicum adults migrate against the portal flow to reside in the mesenteric venules. In case of Schistosoma hematobium, these adults reach the bladder veins through the venous plexus between the rectum and the bladder. So the adult, the schistosomes, definitive venous site in case of Schistosoma mansoni and japonicum is the mesenteric plexus around the gut, and in case of Schistosoma hematobium is the vesical venous plexus around the bladder. These are the definitive venous sites of this adult worms. You know that the Schistosoma female and male adult worms, they are attached together, and the female starts laying fertilized eggs in the definitive venous sites. So the main speciality of the Schistosoma eggs is that they have a spine in their eggs. Mansoni and japonicum, they have lateral spine, and the Schistosoma hematobium has a terminal spine. The eggs penetrate the vascular endothelium. From the vascular system, due to the presence of spine and also a proteolytic enzyme from the myracidium inside the egg, the eggs, they start penetrating the vascular endothelium and enter into the gut and bladder lumen. In case of Schistosoma hematobium, they enter into the bladder lumen, and other schistosomes, they enter into the gut lumen. These eggs are excreted in the stools or urine, and these eggs must enter the fresh water to hatch. So from their location, you can understand the Schistosoma hematobium eggs are found mainly in the urine, as they reside around the bladder and penetrates the vascular endothelium to reach into the lumen of the bladder. And in case of Schistosoma mansoni and japonicum, the eggs are found in the stool. So eggs are released through the stool or urine. So in case of diagnosis, in case of laboratory diagnosis, you have to consider to examine the urine or a stool for microscopy to find out the eggs, characteristics eggs with spine. So eggs must come in contact with the fresh water to hatch. Once hatched, the ciliated larva or Myracidia penetrates the snail. So in fresh water, the eggs hatch and the miracidium comes out. So for the miracidium further developed and multiply in the snail and form the sarcaria. There are production of many sarcaria, and this sarcaria leaves the freshwater snail and starts swimming in the freshwater. And they complete the life cycle by penetrating the human skin.